Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affairs based MCQ series. So in this series, as is clear from its name, we discuss daily 10 MCQs based upon the current affairs of the day. So today is 6 September 2019. So let's see what are the questions of today. So the first question is, consider the following statements related to Dr. S. Radhakrishnan. First, he was the first president of India. Second, he wrote the book The Philosophy of Rabindranath Tagore, which attracted global attention to Indian philosophy. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that he was not the first president of India. In fact, first president of India was Rabindranath Tagore. Rajendra Prasad. So second statement is correct. He wrote the book that is The Philosophy of Rabindranath Tagore. So solution is B. So Teacher Day is observed annually on September 5, as Dr. Radhakrishnan was born on September 5, 1888. So he was not the first president, but he was the first vice president. So he wrote the book The Philosophy of Rabindranath Tagore, and his own philosophy was grounded in Advaita Vedanta. So he defended Hinduism against uninformed Western criticism. So he was a kind of he earned the reputation of a bridge builder between India and the West. So he was one of the founders of Helpage India, a renowned NGO for elderly underprivileged in India. So next is he was awarded the Bharat Ratna, India's highest civilian award, in 1954. So he was awarded several other distinguished awards as well as knighthood in 1931, the honorary membership of the British Royal of Merit in 1963. So now let's move on to second question. Second question is, consider the following statements related to UAPA Act. First, it empowers the government to declare both the association and individuals as terrorist organization and terrorist. Second, it provides for tribunal to contest the orders of the government. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct, that is 1 and 2 both are correct. So it it was recently amended, in which now not only the associations but individuals can be declared as terrorists. So to check the amendments have been criticized on substantial grounds on the basis that they vest too much unchecked power in the central government. So the current debate also throws some light on the functioning of UAPA tribunal. So what are UAPA tribunals and how they are constituted? So tribunals are constituted under this act itself, that is Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, and the role of the tribunal is to review a ban imposed by the government. So basically to ensure the discretionary powers do not prevail of the government, these tribunals, UAPA tribunals, are constituted that review the ban. And the composition of the tribunal is that it will consist of a sitting judge of the High Court. So under section 4 of the UAPA, so this tribunal is tasked with deciding whether there exists sufficient cause for the association to be declared unlawful. So in other words, tribunal must review the grounds mentioned in the notification. So there are different provisions that give sweeping powers to the center. Section 3, subclause 1, it basically authorizes the central government to declare by notification an association unlawful if in its opinion that association is or has become an unlawful association. And this section 3, subclause 1 and 3, subclause 4, require that the notification is given by the publicity and every effort is made to serve it upon the association. So this is about your second question. Next question is, Global Livability Index is released by, released by A. Amnesty International, B. Economist Intelligence Unit, C. World Economic Forum, D. None of the above. So we have to choose the correct statement, that who releases this index. Let me tell you friend that this index is released by Economist Intelligence Unit. So B is the answer. So this year the Vienna city has topped this index. So this has been released. So it ranks 140 global cities based on their living conditions. So significance is that livability index quantifies the challenges that might be presented to an individual's lifestyle in 140 cities worldwide and assesses various which locations provide the best living conditions. So Vienna has topped it for second consecutive year. So basically 30 qualitative and quantitative criteria is taken into consideration while ranking different different cities, and it is divided into five categories, that is stability, healthcare, cultural environment, education and infrastructure. So New Delhi has dropped by 6 places to rank 118, and Mumbai has also fell 2 places since last year to rank 119th. So what are the reasons for decline in livability in Indian cities? So let's see what are the various reasons. So abuses against journalists is the one of the reason, and then rise in crime rates, climatic changes and constrained livability conditions. So please note this, this is very important, and such type of questions help you in mentioning or substantiating your statements that you make in your answers. And next is, consider the following statements related to Dadabhai Naruji. First, he was often called as father of Indian nation. Second, he was the first Indian member of the British Parliament. Let me tell you friends that obviously first statement is wrong, because he was not called father of Indian nation. Rather, Mahatma Gandhi is known the father of the nation. And then yes, he was the first Indian member of the British Parliament. So the answer is B. So September 4, 2019 was 194th birth anniversary of Dadabhai Naroji, grand old man of India. So who was among the first leaders who stirred national consciousness in the country? So he was born in 1825 at Navsari in present day Gujarat. And key contributions were that he was closely involved with Indian National Congress, and he served as the first Indian member of the British Parliament, and his first agitation in 1859 concerned recruitment to the Indian Civil Service. And your next is in 1856 and 65, Naroji helped form the London Indian Society and the East India Association, the two organizations sought to bring nationalist Indians and sympathetic Britons on one platform. And also he served as the secretary of East India Association. He traveled India to gather funds and raise national awareness. And in 1885, he became vice president of Bombay Presidency Association. So served as Congress president thrice. So he was in 1893, he helped forming the Indian Parliamentary Committee to attend to Indian interests. And then in 1895, he became member of the Royal Commission on Indian Expenditure. So he was among the key proponents of the drain of wealth theory, disseminating it in his book Poverty and Un-British Rule in India. So what is drain theory? It was basically that how Indian resources are being drained into Britain. Next is fifth question. Consider the following statements related to advanced pricing agreement. First, it is an agreement between government to government only. Second, it will improve ease of doing business by easing tax compliances. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that yes, it second is correct. Advanced pricing agreement is basically, it helps in improving ease of doing business, but it is not necessary. It is between government to government only. So the answer is B, that is second only. So Central Board of Direct Taxes has entered into this advanced pricing agreement, 26 APAs in first 5 months of the financial year. So basically advanced pricing agreement is an agreement between a taxpayer and a tax authority determining the transfer pricing methodology. So it is not between government to government, but it is rather between the corporate body and between the government. So it provides certainty with respect to tax outcome of the taxpayer's international transactions. So it can be of three types: unilateral, bilateral and multilateral. So this is about your advanced pricing agreement. Next question is six. Consider the following statements related to monetary policy transmission in India. First, it is mandatory for banks to maintain their interest rate in pair with the RBI's repo rate. Second, government has empowered RBI for better monetary transmission through the Banking Regulation Act 1949. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are incorrect. It is not mandatory for the banks So basically, RBI, what it does, basically it reduces the interest repo rate or other interest rates, and it depends upon the bank whether the banks want to transmit or not. So monetary transmission is basically aligning the interest rates of banks with the RBI. So basically, this is shown here in detail. You can see it. So in the mechanism in India is the repo rate is the anchor rate in determining the interest rate in Indian economy. So this is about your sixth question. So this about this you can get more idea in economy. Next is seventh. Recently, Prime Minister has signed a memorandum of understanding for maritime trade route between India and which country? A. Russia, B. Iran, C. Malaysia, D. None of the above. So friends, answer is A. That is Russia. So recently, the Indian Prime Minister was there in the East Economic Summit, I think. So there multiple memorandum of understandings were signed between India and Russia, and one of them was developing trade route between the Vladivostok and your Chennai. So answer is A. So next, let's move on to next question. Next is, consider the following pairs of harvest festival and their respective states. First, Baisakhi, Punjab. Second, Pongal, Odisha. Third, Nuakhai, Tamil Nadu. Fourth, Bhogali Bihu, Assam. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correctly matched. Let me tell you friends that only first and fourth are correctly matched. Bhogali Bihu is the festival in Assam, and Baisakhi is the festival, harvest festival in Punjab. So the solution is A. So Pongal is celebrated basically in Tamil Nadu, and your Nuakhai is the harvesting festival of Odisha. So they have been interchanged. So background is that festival of Nuakhai is the festival to celebrate newly harvested food by the farmers. So background is basically it traces its origin to the Vedic period, where the sages or rishis used to talk about Panch Yajna. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to World Gold Council. First, World Gold Council is an intergovernmental organization. Second, the council gives Kimberley Process certification to ensure that gold mining does not fund for arms conflict. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that none of these statements is correct. The answer, the solution is D. So World Gold Council is basically association consisting of world's leading gold mining companies. So, and it helps to support its members to mine in a responsible way. So there are growing concerns that the newly mined gold could be used to finance armed conflicts in the countries. So there is a need to ensure that the gold that is sold in the market does not indirectly finance such conflicts. So in this regard, World Gold Council has developed the conflict-free gold standard to help companies to provide assurance that their gold is not contributing to conflict. So these are the more details, so you can see them in basically the PDF. You can also pause the video and can read about them. And next is, which of the following statements about Motor Vehicle Amendment Act 2019 is correct? First, the scheme provides for the cashless treatment of the victims during the golden hour. Second, it provides for the replacement of vehicle every 5 years to prevent the air pollution. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Friends, clearly first statement is correct, because yes, there is provision that there will be cashless treatment of the victims during the golden hour. Golden hour is that period in which basically the life could be saved if the first aid and the life saving aid could be given. So regarding second statement is not correct. This is not, there is no such thing that is replacement of vehicle every 5 years. So basically amended act gives the victim some respite, as it provides for an enhanced insurance compensation of rupees 5 lakh in case of a death of a person in a traffic accident, and rupees 2.5 lakh where there is a grievous hurt. So this is about your discussion. So then golden hour is basically, please note this, golden hour is called the period of first 60 minutes from the occurrence of an accident, when the risk of fatality can be minimized to the greatest extent. So it mandates compulsory insurance of all road users, including pedestrians, who will be covered through Motor Vehicle Accident Fund. So it provides for interim relief to be provided to the claimants. So friends, this is all about today's discussion about the daily current affair MCQs. If you like the video, if you like the questions, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, if you want to get the PDFs of these discussions, then you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our contact number, that is 8968920720. So this is our contact number, so and this is our mail. So if in case you are interested to get the PDFs, you can contact us on these details. Obviously there will be a minimum fee, subscription fee for the PDF, and it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability and as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So basically it is rupees 99 per month. So if in case you want to get the PDFs daily, then you can mail or contact us. And also if you don't want to contact us and if you just want to subscribe, then the subscription link is there in the your description box. You can check the description box and can subscribe for the same. And lastly friends, we also have a Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and this will also be provided in the description box. And so on this Telegram channel, what we do, we keep updating various initiatives that have been undertaken by us for the purpose of UPSC CSE preparation. So if in case you want to remain in touch with us relating to your preparation, then you can join our Telegram channel also. So this is all about today's video. Thank you, have a very nice day ahead.